Good morning, students. In today's class of service marketing, we'll start with another new unit. We have completed the unit 1 and today we'll start with unit 2. In unit 2, the first concept that we are going to study is service development process or service product development. So we'll understand how a new service is developed in the forum. For a service organization, how the service organization develops a new service. So this is service development process. So when we say service development process, the service development process means it is an end-to-end process of developing and launching a new service to be sold to the customers. A new service that is conceived that the company wants to sell to the customers. So right from the point of the business strategy to finally the commercialization and post introduction evaluation. This end-to-end process of developing a new service and launching a new service that is finally is to be sold to the customers is known as the service development process. There are different stages which are required to be taken into consideration during the developing of the service. So there are various stages. There are actually 9 stages that we need to understand, and it's a step-by-step process. We have to understand all these 9 steps in order to understand the complete service development process and how a new service is developed by a service organization. The below diagram explains the service development process in detail. So we'll understand the complete end-to-end process by understanding the diagram that is given below, that is in the next slide. So this is the complete diagram. These are the stages through which the end-to-end process where the service through which the service is developed and launched in the market. It is divided into 2 parts, that is the front-end planning and the implementation stages. In the front-end planning, it consists of certain stages, like it is the business strategy development. This is the first stage. Then there is new service strategy development. Once the business strategy has been developed, is a new strategy is developed. Then there is idea generation, 3rd stage. Then the 4th stage is concept development and evaluation. 5th stage is business analysis and evaluation. 6th step, that is, these are the 5 steps for this the front end. When it comes to implementation, these are again 4 steps. Service development and testing. Then comes market testing. Then come commercialization. And finally, post introduction evaluation. So let us understand each of these steps in brief. Then we will understand all these steps in detail in later slides. When we say business strategy development, every organization has an overall mission, vision, and the strategy of doing the business. So the new service idea, the new service we are want to generate, or new service that we want to develop or launch in the market, this new service strategy or this new service idea must fit with the larger picture of the organization or the larger business strategy of the organization. If only it fits with the larger business strategy of the organization, then only we can move forward with this development of the service. Now the second stage is the new service strategy development. What happens in this? In this, a framework is made for the new strategy, and this framework is very important. How the strategy should be developed. This framework is very important for our organization because it allows an organization to identify the possible direction of growth of the service. We'll understand the growth in which the direction in which we can develop or grow the service to make it as a final product. The third stage consists of is known as idea generation. What happens in idea generation? There are various ways of generating this idea. This may be formal brainstorming or getting these ideas from employees, customers, and also learning and researching the ideas of competitors. Because once this idea we get, that idea is generated, it surfaces, it is seen whether it has a good fit with the firm's overall strategy. So if it matches with the firm's overall strategy and the idea is very has having potential, then we will move forward with the development of the idea. Once the idea is generated with the news, again another step stage comes, that is concept development and evaluation. What happens in concept development evaluation? Once the idea surfaces in the idea generation stage, it is regarded as group fit. it is ready for this initial development. And this concept development and evaluation consists with the translating of the service product idea into a service product concept. So a concept is made, this idea is transferred into service concept, product concept, and this service product concept is again evaluated to see that whether it is matching to the overall picture of the business strategy of the organization. Then comes business analysis. This is the another stage after which the concept development evaluation comes, business analysis. What happens in business analysis? The next step is to determine the feasibility and the potential profit implementation of the idea. It is here we analyze the idea. Business analysis is done because business is done for profit. None of the business is done for obviously all businesses are done for profit. So here our aim is to see that the idea that we are generating, the idea that we are developing, making it into a service product concept, this has feasibility and profitability in the market. These are the two parameters on which we test the idea. So this is very important. Then comes another test, that is service development and testing. What happens in service development and testing? This stage requires the translation of the idea into an actual service product. An actual service product is made for the market. And also this service product that is made for the market, the actual service product, the made into a tangible product, this a testing of the service is also done, you know, to understand whether this service will be acceptable by the customers and whether the service will properly function or not. So after the service product and development and testing, then comes market testing. Here the product is actually sent to the market, made finally with the services tested for the market. Actual testing of the product in the of the service product in the market is done. So this gives an idea whether the customers are interested in the service product or not. Then comes commercialization. What is commercialization? This test represents the organization's commitment to the full-scale launch of the service, new service, into the marketplace. So the full-scale launch, there is no testing now. The testing is over. After getting positive reports from the testing stage, market testing stage, the product is directly a full-scale launch of this new service product is done into the marketplace. So the service is finally delivered into the market. And finally comes the last stage, that is post-introduction evaluation. Here the information that is gathered from the commercialization stage, this is evaluated to make to see whether it is properly functioning or not, whether the people are happy with the product or not, whether some changes is required in the delivery process or the staffing or the marketing mix of the service. All these things are kept in mind and proper changes are made in order to make the service product much more profitable in the market, much more competent in the market. So these are the stages through which the service product development takes place, and all these 9 steps are undertaken to finally develop a service, a new service, and market it in the customers. So these are the 9 steps. Now we will understand each of these steps in a much more detailed manner. Here we'll come move from stage 1 to stage all the 9 stages by explaining in detail. The first stage comes with is known as the business strategy development. What happens in business strategy development? As we have already discussed, every organization has an overall business strategy, mission and vision. And the service strategy and idea should be in tandem with the overall business strategy of the organization. That the service strategy that we are making, the new service strategy for the service strategy for the new service we are making, or the service idea, the new service idea, should be in tandem, should be in alignment with the overall business strategy of the organization. This is very important. If it doesn't match the business strategy, mission, vision of the organization, then we cannot move forward with the new service development. Then, if they are not clear on the overall strategic direction of the organization will be misled. Why this is very important? Because if this business strategy development is not done properly, this alignment of this new service strategy and the new service idea with the business strategy of the organization is not done, then it will result in the organization to be misled, to be distracted from the right path. The new service strategy and the new service idea must fit the larger picture of the organization. Therefore, the new service strategy and the new service idea must fit the larger picture of the organization. So this is very important. Therefore, the organization must be clear about the business strategy, mission and vision. Accordingly, the organization must take steps to develop this business strategy. The first step is to review the vision and mission and of the company, and the new service strategy is then developed with specific service idea and see that it is fitting with the larger strategic mission and vision of the organization. So in this we will understand that the new service strategy and the new service idea is matching the overall business strategy of the organization. So this is all the work we have to do in the first stage of the business strategy development. So this means that the service strategy and the idea should be in tandem with the overall business strategy of the organization. This is the first step of the service product development process. Now the second step consists of new service strategy development. Once we have seen the alignment of the new service strategy with the business strategy, we have to also try and develop, dig deeper into the new service strategy and develop the new service strategy. What happens in this type of new service that is appropriate will depend upon the organization mission, vision, capabilities and growth plan. So since we have already discussed that there should be a tandem between this both this business strategy and the new service strategy, this new service strategy will entirely depend upon the organization mission, vision, capabilities and the growth plan. So this is very important to understand. Now what happens, this gives a framework to the organizations to identify the possible directions of the growth. Why this is important? Because it gives the organization a direction and identify the direction in which the service can be further developed. And when we say a new service strategy has to be developed, we have to see possibly in terms of the what will be the market of the for the product, for the software service, what will be the type of the service, what will be the time horizon for the service, within how many days the service will be moving from the various stages of the life cycle of the service, what are the specific profit criteria. All these things has to be kept in mind while developing the new service strategy. But the new service strategy should be developed in such a way that it will help the organization to identify the possible direction and growth of the new service. So this is the second stage of the service product development. Now the third stage consists of idea generation. The next step in the process is the generation of new ideas. Once we have the new service strategy, the service strategy is in place, we have to determine the idea. What are the various ideas for developing the service of the new service? In this phase, the idea generated can be passed to the new service strategy. Once the idea is generated, this can be passed through the new service strategy. Many methods are available for searching out new service ideas. The service ideas can be found out from various ways. So there is not one of the ways, there are many ways in which that can be found out. Ideas from employees, what are the ways? Ideas from employees and customers by feedback. From customers or employers by feedback and learning the competitive service offering are some of the most common approaches which are used for idea generation. So this is very important, and the various methods as we have discussed are generally used for getting new ideas. These ideas can be generated from inside the organization or outside of the organization. Since when we say inside, it's the employees are the inside of the and customers and the competitors are outside of the organization. So it can be developed from inside and outside of the organization. There are various ways in which this can be developed, that maybe through formal brainstorming or structured brainstorming can be done, or unstructured brainstorming can be done. Then soliciting the ideas from employees or customers, lead researchers and learning from competitors. So in these ways, the ideas is generated either from inside the organization or outside the organization. This mechanism might include generating new ideas through the suggestion box from customers or employees. Suggestion box can be used, and the various methods are used for generating this idea. This is very important because once a new idea surfaces, it is regarded as a good fit with the organization's business strategy and the organization's business positioning, then it will be ready for the initial development. So that is the reason this stage is very important, because this stage helps in the idea generation of the new service, and if it is a good fit with the organization's business strategy, the overall new service strategy is in alignment with the organization's business strategy, then it will be ready for the initial development. The idea will be further development to make it a, finally give it a shape into the new service product. This is the third stage of the service product development. Then coming to the fourth stage of the service product development is service concept development and evaluation. Here we are developing the service concept. The idea is converted into a service concept, and this service concept is developed and evaluated to see whether this was, if it is matching the business strategy or not, whether it is feasible or not. After this, the business analysis will come. So we will understand the evaluation is done from the service concept. Evaluation is done from the basis of profitability and feasibility. So what happens in this stage? Once the idea surfaces, that is regarded as a good fit, and it is ready for the initial development, concept development is concerned with translating the service product idea, that is nothing but the idea generation stage, the service product is generated, into a service product concept. Here, the idea that is generated in the third stage is converted into a service product concept. In case of service product concept, it starts with presenting the consumer with description and drawings to get the attention and reaction. This can be developed by presenting the idea to the consumer with description and drawing, telling them what the service concept will be and how it will be developed and how the final product, service product will be. So this will help, this is done to get the attention and also the reaction of the people. So this is very important. Once happens in this, the service idea is given a shape into a service product concept, and it is defined in the functional and objective terms into a service product concept. So this translation should be in the functional and objective terms. So in the strict sense, it will be developed. After the clear definition of the concept, it is important to produce a description of the service that represents its specific features, and then to determine the initial customers and employees' responses to the concept. So what the service concept development includes, it includes the various features the service represents. What will be the final outcome of the service concept? So first of all, service product idea, what will be the complete features? These features are generally shown to this customers and employees to get their attention and reaction. And also customer testing is applicable. Customer testing is done. Concept testing is done, and this is applicable for the evaluation, because this testing gives an idea of the evaluation of the service concept development. So these are the things that are included in this stage of service concept development, whereby the service idea that is developed in the third stage is transferred into, converted into a service product concept, and this service product concept is then shown, consists of the various features, the final outcome, what is the probable outcome. This is shown to the consumers and the employees in order to get their attention, in order to get their reaction, to get their suggestion. Here you have to remember that the product development and the service concept development are little bit different, because the product has more tangible and the service is not tangible. So we have to get this information from the employees and the customers regarding this. So this is the fourth stage. Now coming to the fifth stage, that once the service concept is been developed and evaluated, we have to see whether it can be made into a business. So business analysis or evaluation has to be done. So business analysis and evaluation. What happens in is business analysis and evaluation, assuming the service concept is favorable, in the fourth stage, we have developed the service concept. One, we consider that it is favorable. It is evaluated by the customer and employees at the concept development stage. So this is done. The next step is to determine is feasibility and potential profit implementation. So now we will determine whether the, from a business sense, whether this service concept development stage, once you have developed the concept, whether this is feasible and what is the potential profit implementation. What is the amount of profit that we can gain from this? The organization will pass the results of the business analysis through its profitability and feasibility screen to determine whether the new service idea meets the minimum requirements of the business. So this is very important. We have to pass it through the screen of feasibility and profitability in order to determine whether the service that we are going to shape or give make, it can be made into a business and it meets the minimum requirements of the business organization or the service organization. So demand analysis and cost analysis are the parts of this stage, because the development here we have to understand what is the demand and what is the cost involved in making the service. So this is the operational cost is also taken into consideration. These things are kept in mind in order to determine what is the feasibility. This stage will involve primarily about its cost of hiring and recruiting. So when we are developing a new service, maybe we may be requiring some new talent, new human resource into the organization. So the hiring, recruiting, or there's some training is required of the for the new or the available human talent. That is, what are the training is required, what are the delivery system, and what is the facility, changes in facility has to be made in order to deliver the service. All these things has to be taken into consideration. It involves the understanding of detailed analysis of the attractiveness of the idea in business terms and its likely chances of success or failure. So we have to understand this is the main line. This is the main thing we have to do in business. We have to see that in real terms, in real business terms, how far this business concept or the business idea is favorable, is attractive, and how this will may likely lead to success or failure of the service organization. A substantial analysis will consider in detail the various aspects of manpower required to implement the new service idea, the additional physical resources required, and the physical estimates of sales, cost, profits over time, and the contribution to the overall bottom line of the organization, service organization. These things will be helping. So this passing this business idea, new business idea, or this concept, new service concept, through this feasibility and a potential profit implementation will give an idea to the service organization whether it is will result to the feasibility, it will result to the success or failure of this. So if they find that it will lead to success, then they will move forward with the idea. And if the business analysis is coming out to be positive, they'll move forward with the idea. Otherwise, they will remove this or they'll again go to this idea generation stage. Now, the sixth stage that is very important. Once we have analyzed the service, made the service concept, one, we have made the idea, the service concept is made, and the business analysis also is done. We know that it is feasible in order, and we can potential profits are can be found out. Then we will finally try to develop this. So service development and testing will be done. The service will be developed. This is a very important stage. What happens in this? This stage requires the translation of idea into actual service product for the market. Here the word important is actual service product. In real terms, the service product is made for the market, because the final product, the service product should be made so that this can be tested. So in service development testing, the idea is converted into a real-time actual service product for the market. The tangible elements of the service product will be designed and tested for the consumer acceptance. Why it is done? This actual product is designed and tested for the consumer acceptance, because if the consumer do not accept it, the consumer do not buy into the service product, they are not attracted to the service product, then there is no, then it will not be profitable for the service organization. So in this case, the tangible elements of the service product will be designed and tested for the consumer acceptance. The testing of the service is done to gauge why the testing service development we understood for understanding the attractiveness of the and acceptable to the consumer. Why service testing is done, testing of service is also done to gauge the probable acceptability of the consumer. This is one part of it, and also to ensure proper functioning of the service. We have to see that the service is also functioning properly. So for that reason, testing is done. So what happens in this stage? The services are intangible in nature. The services are intangible in nature and are produced and consumed simultaneously. Therefore, this stage is little bit difficult to address this new challenge. This step of service development involves all those who are part of the services, of the service, like the customers, the employees, as well as the functional head representing the marketing. They play a vital role at this stage. It involves the construction of a product prototype. Actual, as we have said, the actual service product is developed. This actual service developed, service product that is developed, this is a prototype. This is the initial type of the product is made, and then it is tested. So prototype is dead and testing for customer acceptance is done. So this is very important. So testing of the product is done. This is why this is done, because here we want to see whether the service can be developed and tested, and whether this new service will be accepted for the market, accepted by the customers, and the service that is functioning properly and is satisfying the needs of the consumer. So these are the things we need to assign in order to understand these things. If we do not do the development of the service and testing, then it is of no use. So to monitor the aspects of service during the introductional and the promotional activity are more to commercialize the service. So this is help in the further market testing and commercializing of the service. Okay, so this is the sixth stage. Now coming to the seventh stage, that is market testing. Once a prototype has been made, once the actual service product has been made, it has been tested by the consumers and the accept is seen that it is going to be acceptable by the consumers and employees, it has been seen appreciated by the employees, then it is the finally the product, the prototype, the final prototype is tested in the real market in order to see whether the people are interested to buy the product or not, service product or not. At this stage of the development process, that is, the service might be tested for the market. The final service is tested for the market. At this stage, pilot study has to be done for the service to be sure that the operational details are functioning smoothly. Why this market testing is done? We have to see that the operational aspects are operational details are functioning. Operational part, there is no problem. The service delivery is done properly. The service is functioning properly. All the aspects of the services are functioning properly. So this is market testing. So in this stage, we are mainly concerned with the pilot study of the service to see that the operational details are functioning smoothly. The new service might also be offered in this stage to the employees and their families in order to understand for a particular period of time, maybe for 2 months, for 3 months, this may be the new service will be provided or delivered to the employees or their families for a particular period of time for testing of the service. And this is market testing because these people constitute the market, they are part of the market. So these are given for the testing, and they will access, we will access, we will examine the responses of the service and determine whether the service is proper or not, whether it is properly, the marketing mix is properly done, whether the pricing is done properly for the service, whether the service product is, what are the various features it is qualifying or satisfying the various needs and wants of the consumers, and the place where the service will be delivered, how far will the way the in which the service will be delivered, and what is the promotional things that will be done, how to promote the service. All these things are done. If I give you an example, a very beautiful example of market testing that was done is of a service is by Jio. Reliance Jio was offered to its employees for testing the service and determining the market strategy. So the Jio, before launching into the complete market, real market, it was given to for testing to this employees and his family members, so that they will undertake the service, they will assess the service, and then they can tell what would be the marketing mix and whether the service is satisfying their needs or not. Then after market testing, everything is done, we find that the service is very good. Now we can open it to the market. There will be final commercialization. This full will go full frontal and will launch the product in the market. The 8th stage is known as commercialization. What happens in commercialization? This stage represents our organization's commitment to a full-scale launch of the service product. Represents the organization's commitment to a full-scale launch. So not any limited, it's a full scale launch. In market testing, there was a limited, but here there's a full scale launch of the new service product. What happens at this stage in the process development? The service goes live and is introduced in the marketplace. The service is live, it is given completely in the full scale launch into the market, live market, and it is introduced into the marketplace. So these are the main things that happens in commercialization. Why this commercialization stage is important? This stage has primarily two objectives. The stage's objective first is to build and maintain the acceptance of the new service and to see that the proper service delivery is done and day-to-day maintaining of the service quality is done. In commercialization, we have to see that the service that we are giving, that is properly delivered, and the service process delivery is proper, and day-to-day maintaining of the service quality is done. And secondly, we have to monitor the various aspects of the service from the introduction and through the complete service life cycle. We have to see from the introduction through the complete service life cycle what are the various aspects of the service. We have to monitor that. So we'll understand what bottlenecks we are having, why the service is in commercializing stage, we can find out why the service is not functioning properly, what are the shortcomings, in which way we can make changes so that this commercialization stage can be a success. So at this stage of the process development, the service goes live and is introduced to the marketplace. Okay, introduced to the marketplace. So this happens in commercialization. Full-scale launch of the service is done in the live marketplace. Then the final stage, that is post-introduction evaluation. After you have introduced the product into the market in the commercialization stage, now we will evaluate the information that we have gathered in the commercialization stage in order to make further changes in the service, new service product that we are giving it to the customer. So what happens at this stage, the information gathered during the commercialization of the service, this information is evaluated and changes are made in the delivery process, maybe in the staffing, the people who are giving the front row employees who directly meet the customers in order to deliver the service. If they are not properly trained, if they need some changes in their behavior, so this comes under staffing. If some new people with new skill set are required in order to deliver the service, so changes in staffing is done, or marketing mix variables, maybe in the product, in the price, in the place, in the promotion, all these variables, these are again shuffled. These changes are made if there is any way in which we can improve so that the penetration of the service in the market is more on the basis of the actual offering to the market response. So after looking at the market response, after gathering this information from this commercialization stage, it is evaluated in order to make change in the three parts, maybe in the staffing, maybe in the delivery process, or in the marketing mix variables. So in this way, this is done. So these are the And this is also a very important stage, because this stage of post introduction and evaluation will ensure that the service is properly delivered in the market, that the people are interested in buying the service, and the service is satisfying the various needs and wants of the customer. So this stage is very important in order to understand the various aspects of the service and to improve the various shortcomings of the new service product. So these are the various stages through which this service product development takes place. A new service product is introduced in the market. This is the end-to-end process of how the services, new service is conceived, developed, and launched into the market. Okay. So these are the 9 stages. I feel you must be understanding. There is no doubt. If again, if you feel there is certain doubts, you can contact me. I will be sending you the notes digitally. Please go through that notes. And if you have any problem, contact me. No need to panic. Stay at home. Be prepared. And finally, thank you for your attention.